It's hard to breathe, but that's alright. Hush. What's up, everybody? Today's the day. Today is the day I get my new-to-me Ducati Monster 1200S. And we have a long drive ahead of us. It's about 5.5 hours in driving from Jersey all the way up to Vermont, and then from Vermont back to Jersey. It's a little rainy out, a little cloudy, but it's a beautiful day to me because I get to pick up my new toy. Let's do it. What do you think, bud? Getting ready to go? What's going on? We are on our way to Vermont. It's gonna be about a 5-hour drive. A 2015 Ducati Monster 1200S in white, my favorite color. 3,000 miles, it's gonna be about $97.50, I think it was what we negotiated. He wanted 11 grand for it, but $97.50 is actually a pretty good deal because it has the Termignoni exhaust kit on it. And it's completely stock other than that. It's a car dealership and they took it in as a trade-in. So he said anything over $9,500, he'd be break even at least. So I was like, all right, I'll give you $97.50, and he took it anyway. So it's currently 3 o'clock. I should probably be there around 8:30 given the breaks that I'm going to take in between. But I actually have a tow truck that I'm using. It's pretty cool. It's got a lift gate on it. The whole ramp comes down, hydraulic system and all. You'll see it in action a little bit. Alright, so we are currently in Malden, New York. So let me show you where that is exactly on the map. We start off right around here, all the way up the New York State Thruway, and we're here. And where we need to go is somewhere here, to Vermont. So we got about 2.5 hours left. So we're gonna keep going now, get back on 87 North to Vermont. Let's do this. Hey, is this Chip? Hey man, it's Ed. I'm coming up to pick up the bike.
Yeah, how you doing?
Good. I was giving you an update. I got some traffic. It says 8:15 ETA.
Okay.
Alright, just giving you, to let you know.
Just give me a heads up when you get closer, please.
Okay, no worries.
Sounds good, thank you.
Okay, bye. An hour and 50 left to go. So right now I'm just gonna take a little drink because I'm tired. Welcome to Vermont. There it is. Ducati 696, the Monster.
Yeah.
And it sits 29.5 inches.
Yeah.
And this one sits 31.3. And for me, that makes a big difference.
Sure.
But it has an adjustable height.
Yeah.
So like the seat comes out and there's like four like little hockey pucks.
Yeah.
They come off.
Take them out. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then I'll be able to ride. But this is nice.
It's a gorgeous bike.
Was it like a trade-in or?
It was traded at the BMW dealer here in town.
Mm. Can I turn it on here? Or?
Of course, yeah. Key's in it. Yep. You know more about it than I do, so.
Thanks a lot, bro. Appreciate it. Here we go. Here's a baby with the dramatic smoke. There she is. 12 hours of round trip for this sexy beast right here. Brand new tires, single side swing arm, oil and suspension, so good. All right, we made it, here it is, here's my baby, 2015 Ducati Monster 1200S. It's in really, really good condition. Got the Termignoni exhaust right here. This is about a $1,500 option. A couple little things here, like an aftermarket little oil fill cap. We have some bar end weights, Ducati Performance there. So here's the thing. I can't ride this bike comfortably, being that I'm only 5'1". Ducati actually sells an OEM seat that's 20 millimeters lower, which makes a big difference. And then I also found a guy on eBay selling one that was 40 millimeters lower. So actually, the way it sits now, it's 31.9 inches at the highest setting, and at the lowest setting is 30.9 inches. Now that's about half an inch higher from a Ducati Monster 696 stock height. I can ride the 696 no problem. I just have to wear some boots and I can almost flat foot. And I believe the way to lower the bike is to remove from what I read was four little little hockey puck looking stoppers under here, rubber grommet things. You take those off and you get that extra inch of lowering. I also got some sliders that go right over here over the frame, and then some engine covers to protect the trans and the engine cover underneath. All right, and the parts that I ended up ordering, I did a lot of research. The Evotech sliders and engine guards are probably the nicest looking ones, but they're about double the price. And when we're talking about parts, there's a certain point where the price kind of really overcomes the quality, I'd say. Like, there's a happy medium where it's price and quality. So I ended up getting a RNG brand engine case covers, which are these. And then I also got the RNG, the sliders, the crash protectors. So they're going to be like pretty big pucks right here. And it sits above the center line of the bike, so that when it drops, it won't hit the tank. It'll actually just kind of balance there on the puck itself. In the next video, I'm actually gonna install all this stuff along with the 40 millimeter seat, and also do a comparison of what the difference is. Especially, it makes a big difference because I'm only 5'1". So I'm really excited for that. Thank you so much for joining me on this 12-hour journey. It's actually the next day. I had to sleep because I could barely keep my eyes open last night. Shout out to NJ Rent-A-Scooter. If you guys need help with getting your motorcycle license in New Jersey, New York, or Philadelphia, I'm the guy to call. All right, so you're probably wondering why the clickbaity title of I got a Ducati for almost free. Well, it's not really clickbait. Let me tell you why. The first, I own a business, I'm a business owner, so this bike is gonna get registered under my business name. I'm a motorcycle instructor for a living, so you can bet I'm gonna be doing a lot of riding and house calls with this bike, which also leads to business use. So if I'm using it for business, you get to write it off in your taxes. Now, how do you write it off in your taxes? It's one magical word, it's called depreciation. Now, what is depreciation? That means the reduction of value of an asset with the passage of time, due in particular to wear and tear. Basically, it means that everything has a life expectancy and eventually it's gonna be worthless. So to break it all down real quick, let's do some number crunching. I bought the bike for $97.50 plus taxes. Here in Jersey, it's 6.625%. That comes out to $645. Insurance is about $500 a year, commercial, full coverage. Registration, $193. Sliders and safety gear, that's about $1,000. Now, you cannot deduct mileage for a commercial motorcycle under the current IRS rules because it would give motorcycles an unfair advantage. It currently sits as of 2019 at 54.5 cents per mile that you get back as a tax credit for every mile you drive your vehicle. Now, there is a limit on how much you can deduct on a commercial auto or truck. It's like 30 to 40% per year. But on a commercial motorcycle, there is absolutely no limit. If you use it 100% for business use, you get to deduct 100% of the expenses. That includes everything from registration, insurance, the cost of the actual bike, my helmet, my sliders that I bought, the engine covers, all that stuff, that's all deductible. So the total cost of the bike comes out to about $12,088. Now, let's just say I don't use the bike for 100% business use. Let's say I use it for 75% business use. That comes out to a grand total of $3,022.24 for my new-to-me 2015 Ducati Monster 1200S. Full disclaimer, I am not an accountant. I am not a CPA. Consult your accountant. Consult your CPA for tax write-offs. Oh, there you have it, folks. Like, comment, and subscribe. I'm going to post another video of the bike and how I make it more rider-friendly for myself for being a short rider. And then I'm going to move on to maybe doing some motorcycle vlogging. Who knows? We'll see. So I'll see you next time. I live inside my own world of make